Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good evening.
Good evening.
We celebrate with the whole church today the feast day of St. Bartholomew, one of the 12 disciples, who turned from their lives to follow the Lord. As we gather together, we offer our Mass tonight for Justin Whitehead, close to his anniversary. Not why I have it, it says in the news letter. I'm sorry about that. Close to his anniversary.
Yeah.
But also there's a typo. Instead of Whitehead, Wirehead.
Oh, okay.
So are you sorry about
that? I couldn't get it on another
one. Good, you can notice that. I just gave it away. Anyway, our prayers are with you and your family tonight. And so to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, we call to mind. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth
peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are strengthen in us, O Lord, the faith by which you blessed Apostle Bartholomew, clung wholeheartedly to your Son, and grant that through the help of his prayers, your Church may become for all the nations the sacrament of salvation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the Apocalypse. The angel came to speak to me and said, "Come here and I will show you the bride that the Lamb has married." In the spirit, he took me to the top of an enormous high mountain and showed me Jerusalem, the holy city, coming down from God out of heaven. It had all the radiant glory of God and glittered like some precious jewel, crystal clear diamond. The walls of it were of a great height and had 12 gates. At each of the 12 gates there was an angel, and over the gates were written the names of the 12 tribes of Israel. On the east there were 3 gates, on the north 3 gates, on the south 3 gates, and on the west 3 gates. The city walls stood on 12 foundation stones, each one which bore the name of one of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your friends, O Lord, make known the glorious splendor of your reign. Your friends, O Lord, make known the glorious splendor of your reign. All your creatures shall thank you, O Lord, and your friends shall repeat their blessing. They shall speak of the glory of your reign and declare your might, O God. Your friends, O Lord, make known the glorious splendour of your reign. They make known to me your mighty deeds and the glorious splendour of your reign. Yours is an everlasting kingdom. Your rule lasts from age to age. Your friends, O Lord, make known the glorious splendour of your reign. The Lord is just in all his ways and loving in all his deeds. He is close to all who call him, who call on him from their hearts. Your friends, O Lord, make known the glorious splendour of your reign. Alleluia, alleluia. Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, "We have found the one who Moses wrote about in the law, the one about whom the prophets wrote. He is Jesus, son of Joseph from Nazareth." "From Nazareth," said Nathanael, "can anything good come from that place?" "Come and see," replied Philip. When Jesus saw Nathanael coming, he said of him, "There is an Israelite who deserves the name, incapable of deceit." "How do you know me?" said Nathanael. "Before Philip came to call you," said Jesus, "I saw you under the fig tree." Nathanael answered, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God, you are the King of Israel." Jesus replied, "You believe that because I said I saw you under the fig tree. You will see greater things than that." And then he added, "I tell you most solemnly, you will see heaven laid open, and above the Son of Man, the angels of God ascending and descending." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Like many of the apostles, there is not a great deal said about the majority of them in the Gospels. We do have, though, tonight the account of the calling of Nathanael or Bartholomew, who is brought to Jesus by Philip. And in the first instance, Bartholomew, Nathanael, is rejectful of the thought that Jesus from Nazareth was the Christ. What good can come from that place? Nazareth must have had a bit of a bad reputation. And yet, through encountering Jesus, his heart is converted, and immediately he says, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God, you are the King of Israel." That encounter with Jesus must have changed his heart and his mind, and from that moment on he would become an apostle of the Lord. Tradition has it is that he went to India, but was martyred in Armenia, after which his remains were taken to Rome and interred on an island in the middle of the Tiber. If you've been to Rome, it's quite a prominent island, and for many centuries it acted as a hospital. And because Bartholomew's relics are there, he has become the patron saint of the sick. We ask for his prayers today, and indeed we pray for all those who are sick at this time. Saint Bartholomew, pray for us.
So let us turn to the Lord with our prayers of faith this day. We pray for the Church on this feast day of St. Bartholomew, for all of God's people, that they may walk in the footsteps of the Apostles. Lord, hear our mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Pray for our Lord in his many needs this time. We keep particularly in our prayers still the people of Afghanistan. Pray for just future for those people. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for ourselves in our journeys of faith, that inspired by the disciples, we too may know that our work and prayer are always in the good of the Church. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are sick in mind or in body. We pray that they may find healing and peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who have died and those whose anniversaries occur at this time, that they may rest always with God, the saints, and his angels. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We ask for the prayers of Mary, Queen of the Saints, as we pray to you.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
We make these and all our prayers through Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given, which human hands have made, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God for ever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God for ever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the whole Church.
As we celebrate anew the feast of St. Bartholomew, O Lord, we pray that we may obtain your help through the intercession of the Apostle, in whose honour we bring you this sacrifice of praise. Through Christ.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is true, right and just. Our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you, Eternal Shepherd, do not desert your flock. Through the blessed apostles, watch over it and protect it always, so that it may be governed by those you have appointed shepherds, to lead it in the name of your Son. And so, the angels and archangels, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holiness and gifts we pray, descending down your spirits upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion. He took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, Justin Whitehead, for whom we offer this Mass, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Bartholomew, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours for ever and ever.
Amen.
Saviour's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord with you all.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the Son of the Lord.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
pray together, perhaps a spiritual communion with those who are still unable to join us physically from the Mass. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since many count and smoke must receive you sacramentally, come to you spiritually into their hearts. We embrace you as if you were there already, and unite our souls only to you. Never permit us to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. This divine sacrament enlighten and inflame us, Almighty God, on this feast day of Blessed Saint Bartholomew. We have received the pledge of eternal salvation, O Lord, and we pray that it may be of help to us, both now and for the life to come, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.